A brush created in Affinity Designer can be used in Affinity Photo. How to do that? I've got both applications open, Photo and Designer. I'm in Designer now, and I've created a brush earlier. Please check out my videos on that. And go over here to the Tools panel, Vector Brush Tool, and Apply. Now I'm using no color, width 210, and just adding it like this. You can see the brush over here in the Brushes panel. And you can create multiple brushes or a single brush stroke, which you can apply all the way over like that. And as you do it, you'll see it changes. It's a vector design that can be then manipulated later. But you can also manipulate it in Photo. Go to File and Edit in Photo. You don't have to select anything, it will use this document. In Photo, you'll notice over here in the Layers panel, View Menu Studio and Layers, it's still a curve, still a vector design. However, there's no vector brush. That isn't added, unfortunately, when you go into Photo. However, you can still manipulate it. If you look at it and think, oh, I want that to be slightly changed, just go here. Node tool. Select the node tool in the Tools panel, and you'll see all the nodes of this. So you can just move it. You say, oh, I want to shift that bit. Maybe this one's slightly wrong. I can move that, and so on. So you can tweak it in that way. With it selected, if you want to recolor it, you decide, I don't want the original colors. Go up here to stroke, click there, and then you can set it to red, blue, etc. If you want it returned to what it was before, just click here, that little nil, and you got back the original colors. With the brush selected, you can go over here to the Transform panel. You can find that in View Menu, Studio, and Transform. And you can rotate it. Just rotate it. It's still a vector design. You can also shear it. So you can just shear it like that, and it still remains a vector design, as well as, of course, reposition and scale. With it selected, you can also apply filter effects. If you do that, it will be turned into a pixel layer. So filters, blur, and Gaussian blur, any of them. As soon as you do that, click apply, you'll notice you've got a pixel layer. You may not want that if you want it to be still a vector. So undo, back to a curve. You can go to layer and add adjustment layers, and that will not change it from a vector to a pixel, as well as new live filter layers. And you can go to blur, Gaussian blur again, or distort, say ripple, twirl, etc. I'm just going to go with twirl. And you can just change it, modify it, and you can see the distortion there. And close that. And you can see there, you've got your twirl added to that curve. It's still a vector design. You can also recolor it using the adjustments. Layer, new adjustment layer, and go down to HSL or any of the others and just recolor it. As you do that, you can see the colors there. And again, it's still live and you can still modify it at any time in the future. You can also define this as a brush. Got here, layers. Unfortunately, you need to rasterize it. Go to layer and merge visible. Everything will be merged into one pixel layer. With that pixel layer selected, you can then go, you've got it selected over here, brushes panel, view menu, studio and brushes, right side, and new brush from selection. And then it's saved as a new brush here. It's not a vector design, it's still a pixel design, but you can then use it with the standard brush tools over here in the Tools panel. With the adjustment layer again, and the curve and the twirl effect, what you can now do is you can go back into Designer. You can use this in Designer. So File and down to Edit in Designer, or Publisher if you've got Publisher, but edit it in Designer and it will load in a few seconds, and there's your design. Layers. You can still see it there. You can expand it out. You've got all the various filter effects and the adjustments all added with the curve, which is still live. With the curve selected in Designer, you can go over here to the brushes again and select any of these brushes and just uses this adjustment as well as the twirl. So if I click there, and that's a variation of this brush, you can see the design now with that twirl as well as the adjustment. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Thank you much.